I think in life there's different places where people find their peace and their calm, and for me it's definitely music. The emotion that's felt through that music and the characters that you get to portray hurt on a very different level, and they love on a different level. I started singing at the age of 7, and that was kind of something I was born into. My family was very musical. My great aunt was a concert pianist and played all over Australia. My grandfather wrote music and also played the piano as well. It just came naturally to me. When I was 15 years old, I had a cardiac arrest at the aquatic centre, swimming in a relay race. Dived in, halfway up the pool, I started to just really weird, and I remember kind of just slurring my way through the pool. I ended up having a cardiac arrest in the water. Somehow I made it to the end of the pool, and my sister and another girl jumped in and pulled me out. They did resuscitation for about 20 minutes. When I was getting in the ambulance, I thought, if I'm not dead, I'll be able to sing a song. So I actually started to sing. And after genetic testing following that, they realised that it was a gene mutation that caused the heart to go into fibrillation through adrenaline. So the prognosis for the condition is called CVPT. In short, it's basically a sudden death syndrome. It's untraceable, and it just comes on at any point in time. After we were diagnosed, the doctors recommended that I wasn't to swim again. No weights, no running, no sport whatsoever, obviously because it was adrenaline that brought it on. But after 6 months of coming out of hospital, I was on the stage in Sydney with the Sydney Symphony Orchestra singing in a national competition. It's had its moments where I've been scared, but it certainly never stopped me from doing anything. I just refused. With my singing, I moved to Sydney to further my career over there and what I was doing. And when I was in Sydney, I was in a few competitions over there and I was winning them. I was doing really well. And then all of a sudden, it just all caved in. I noticed that my voice started to play up. And when I went to get my throat checked, there was a mucosal cyst on my vocal cord. And for me, that was like my world had just came crashing down. And they said, we have to operate and laser it off. I was lucky enough to have no scarring or no issues with it until I went to Melbourne, and I felt still that something wasn't right. And they found another one underneath the vocal cord. So that was operated on as well. After both the surgeries that I have, recovery has taken 5 years. For a while there, I couldn't string even two notes together. It's an emotional recovery as well. With the support of my teacher, Glenn, and family, I've been able to pull myself up and be able to sing right back to where I was before, but almost better, because I have that emotional experience and the gratitude to be able to do it again as well. This Saturday, I'll be doing my first recital back after 5 years. It's important because I haven't been able to bring myself to sing in front of people in this kind of setting. For me, it's more the emotional toll on it. It's being able to kind of hit rock bottom and drag yourself back up again, and there's a lot of self-doubt comes into it. You know how it's supposed to feel, but it doesn't feel the way it needs to feel. And I think now I've gotten to a point in preparing for this, it's just to be brave and do. I've learned to love that my weaknesses are my greatest strengths, and even though they come at a cost, there's something that also gives me great joy. So I've had two extreme events that have been really unlucky, heart, voice, but the things that have come out of that have been great relationships, the ability to pull myself out of something, and also the gratitude I have for those people and for my life as well. It's just about enjoying the small moments, because if you plan too far ahead and rush, you're missing all the stuff that's important to you.